Hi friends! I'm going to talk to you today about statistical process control for rare events. When does this happen? Have you ever driven past a factory and you see they have a sign out front that says, you know, we are 22 days injury free, things like that. Those are the kinds of situations where you might want to use a rare event chart. How much time is it between events? Why would we use that? Well, when something is super, super rare, it just really doesn't happen very often, especially these are usually things that are bad, but something really, really rare. If you were to use a control chart for attributes, so if you saw the video on control charts, you'll remember the C chart was one of those. That would have been something you could use. Count how many times an accident happens and plot it. However, when you have something that's really rare, that plot is going to look like 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. And anytime you have a 1, it's just about guaranteed to be outside of the control limits. And it still might be a controlled process. So a different way to conceptualize it, instead of thinking of that as a Poisson counting process, you can think of it as a geometric distribution. How many trials until an event occurs. And that follows the geometric distribution. And there's a type of control chart for that. And it uses PROC rare events in SAS-QC. Let me give you another example. I have two dogs. These are my dogs, Esme and Freya. They look a lot alike. They're both boxers and they're both really sweet, except that Freya, I'm drawing some little horns on her because she's a bad dog. Sometimes she likes to eat her bed. So we give her a bed and she sleeps on it and she's a happy dog sleeping on her bed. And then she gets bored and nom, 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 nom. She chews up her bed. This doesn't happen very often. So what I like to do is I like to keep track of every day when I come home from work, has she eaten her bed? And most of the time, she hasn't. Every once in a while, she has. And then I get her a new bed, and then the bed's okay for a while until she gets bored, and then she eats her bed. Well, now, why don't I conceptualize this as a geometric chart or as a rare events chart? What I can do is I can say how many days went by before she actually ate her bed. In this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm gonna call this days between eating her bed. So 5 is my first observation. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more days go by before she eats her bed again. And then 1 more day goes by before she eats her bed. So the first 3 data points are just going to be 5, 5, and 1. And I can plot those on a control chart of days between over time. And we can look for signals on that chart. Now, what you want to see actually in a case like this is you want to see a lot of days between. You don't want to see a lot of values of 1 because that means she's eating her bed every day. But that's neither here nor there. I'm going to show you how to create these charts in PROC Schuhart. First, let's look at our data set. The data set I'm going to start showing you is just called billing errors, and I'll provide links to the data for you. And what I have is I have the billing date of an error. So these are just the dates that the errors occurred. If you plotted this on a control chart, you would have 1 and then 2 and then 0 and then 1 and then 0 and 1. And then you go a lot of zeros until you got to this one here. What I've done here is I've just gone ahead and put in just an index of error numbers. And then how many days between? The first value is a missing value in this particular data set. I'm giving you a heads up on that because you'll see a warning in the log about missing values. It's okay. It's because the first one, we don't know how many days between because that's the first error that we see. But then how many days between? It's 1, 0, 2, 2, and then a span of 21 days with no errors and a span of 12 days with no errors. We're really happy about that. How do we construct this chart for a geometric distribution? How do I know it's a geometric distribution, first of all? The procedure we're going to use is called PROC rare events. And PROC rare events, if your data are integers, the default distribution is a geometric distribution. It will accommodate other distributions as well. So I'm putting in proc rare events, and I'm using compare days between process equals bar reference equals marker. What that's going to do is enable me to see whether this looks like it's approximately a geometric distribution. And process equals bar is going to use bars for my distribution of the observed values. And then reference equals marker will put dots as the reference lines for the geometric distribution. And then chart days between. Let me just go ahead and run the first part of this so you can see what that looks like. So comparing this to a geometric distribution, it's not terrific, but it's not horrible. So we'll go ahead and go with that geometric distribution. And you can see we have days between is a lot of times one or two. So there's, you know, plenty of times that we have billing errors consecutively. That's not great. But then we also have, you know, this nice big 21-day run out here. We'd kind of like to know what happened there. Then I'm going to add in the chart statement, and it's so easy. We just say chart days between. So when I run chart days between, what it's plotting is a rare events chart using a geometric distribution for probability limits. They're not quite exactly the same as control limits. Control limits are based on 3 times the estimate of the sigma within samples, or the estimate of the variability within samples. This is using a probability limits, right? And it has some automatic built-in tests for 3 consecutive points outside of limits, all right? So you can see if this appears to be out of control, and it looks pretty good. So nothing too unusual there. Another way that we could look at this is with data that are interval. So the rare events chart that we just saw for billing errors had integers for days between errors. But sometimes what you have is a continuous measurement of time, like we have in this staff data set. This is the days between staff infections in a hospital, and this is measured in decimals. With data that are measured in decimals, the default distribution will be the exponential distribution. There are other choices as well, but we'll go ahead and run the default here. So proc rare events, and we'll compare our days between to the default distribution, which is the exponential. And it does look like a pretty good fit. I went ahead and used the default settings here, so it uses a curve instead of dots for the distribution that's theorized. We can compare our distribution to some statistical tests for the distribution, and then we get our rare event chart for days between. And you can see that we've got days between infections, and it continues on for a second chart because it's got lots and lots of points. Somebody's going to ask, and if you want to know how do I make sure that all of those points stay on one control chart, we're going to say tote panels equals 1. And that's my little trick to make sure they all squeeze onto one panel. So that's how you construct rare event charts. If you want to know a little bit more about rare event charts, there are some good references for you in the documentation. I'm going to go ahead and go to the documentation for SAS-QC, and in the rare events procedure, you can learn all about it here. There's an overview. You can go to the getting started. These are some references that let you understand how these charts work, and then there are lots of examples in here as well. So thanks for joining me in this video. I hope you learned something cool. I definitely had a good time talking to you about how to do this stuff in SAS. Make sure you check out the links below in the description. There'll be some additional information, some things for you to go check out. Also, leave me a comment. Let me know what you like. Let me know if you have any questions. Be sure you click that like button and tell your friends, tell your family, tell your neighbors, and subscribe to the SAS Users channel. Until next time, have a great day. Thank you.